Assalamu alaikum, my dear students. I hope that you're all well by the grace of Almighty Allah. Alhamdulillah, I'm also fine by the mercy of Almighty Allah. Welcome to NIVS Home School. This is Mizanur Rahman, Assistant Teacher of Islam Studies of National Delhi University School, Day Shift, Bonasri, Dhaka. Today, I'm going to take an Islam Studies class for the students of Class 4. Our today's topic is Chapter 2, page number 21 to 22, discussion. Today, Class 4. Term manual and subject Islam. Okay, dear students, now come to the board and listen. Chapter 2, page number 21. Ibadat. Its Arabic is Ibadatun. Ibadat means to slavery, to abide by the order of the Lord. Okay, dear students, it is the what meaning of the Ibadat? To work according to the order of Allah, the great and his rasuls is called ibadat. This is the Islamic terminology about ibadat. Okay, to work according to the order of Allah the great and his rasul is called ibadat. Islamic terminological meaning of ibadat. The meaning of the word ibadat is wide. For example, to perform salat, to recite the Quran Majid, to give nursing the sick, and to tell the truth, all these are ibadat. Okay, dear students, if come in the examination, what do you mean by ibadat? Then you have to write down from here to here and give any one example, such as performing salat or giving zakat. Identity of ibadat. Allah the Great said in the Quran Majid, I, Allah, have created the jinnah and mankind only that they might do ibadat towards me alone. It means I will serve only for Allah the great and for not others. Number two, we will abide by the order of Allah the great only and not on others, not by others. Number three, We will bow down our heads only before him, not before others. Number four, we will fear him only, not others. Number five, we will seek help only from him, not from others. Okay, these five aspects are explained by Allah the Great for the word ibadat. This is the real meaning of ibadat in the ayats of the Quran Majid, where Allah the Great has ordered to us perform it. The substance of the teachings of our beloved Prophet Hazrat Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and all of his preceding prophets is, do not perform ibadat for anyone but Allah. We used to declare that this aspect when we read Surah Fatiha in every rakat of Salat. Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in. It means we worship and your aid do we seek. Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in. Okay, dear students, we are all time recite in the performing of Salat, in the reciting the Surah Al-Fatiha, Iyyaka na'budu wa Iyyaka nasta'in. You do your shift and your aid do we seek. Allah is the Great has made different kinds of ibadat obligatory or false. For us, for example, Salat, five time prayers, Psalm or fasting, Zakat, poll tax, and Hajj, pilgrimage to Makkah. Okay, now we'll start Taharat, purity. Taharatun. Allah the Great says, Allah loves them who keep themselves pure. Our Great Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam says, purity is a part of Iman. At-tuhuru shatrum minal Iman. To remain clean and pure is called Taharat. Okay, dear students, it is the definition of Taharat. To remain clean and pure is called Taharat. If come in the examination, what do you mean by Taharat? Then you have to write to remain clean and pure is called taharat. Taharat means cleanliness and purity. Taharat means, what meaning is taharat is cleanliness and purity. For example, to make wuzu, ablution, and to bath, and to take bath, etc. This is the definition of taharat. Okay, dear students, those who keep themselves pure and clean, put on clean clothes, are loved by all. They are praised by all. If we remain clean and pure, we feel good in body and mind, and we feel good to pay attention to studies. Then Allah is pleased. Ablution, wuzu. In the Holy Quran, Allah has command to us to wuzu, ablution, before performing salat. There are many rules to follow for keeping oneself clean and pure. Wuzu before salat is the best of them. To make wuzu before salat is farz. To make wuzu before salat is a farz. Dear students, it's come in the hadith, at-tuhuru miftahu salat. Salat cannot be offered without wuzu. Dear students, we know that come in the hadith, al-wuzu miftahu salat. So we have to must take ablution before performing salat, because without performing wuzu or without taking purity, we cannot perform our salat. Because without wuzu, our salat cannot be acceptable to the Almighty Allah. So it is obligatory to do ablution or wuzu before performing salat. Dear students, Allah the Almighty declared in the Holy Quran, there are four obligatory things in the wuzu, such as there are four compulsory for the items of wuzu. There are four compulsory items in wuzu. For example, to wash face thoroughly. Number two, to wash hands well from the tips of the finger up to the elbow. Number three, to rub lightly at least over 1/4 of the head. Number four, to wash the feet up to the ankles. Okay, dear students, it's enough for today's lecture. Now I want to give AW on the basis of today's lecture. What do you mean by purity? Write for us items of wuzu. Today's AW number 1 for annual term and topic of today's AW, what do you mean by purity? Write for us items of wuzu. Okay, dear students, you have to write down from here. Purity, definition of purity is here, and write down for the item of wuzu from here to here as a HW. Okay, dear students, I hope that you have understood this topic clearly. Keep practicing at home, avoid bad parents, stay well. See you again very soon, inshallah, with another topic. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.